Hi everyone, I am Sergey. Thanks for the invitation. I'm really glad to be here. So, woodland archaeology, right? Colonization of the territory of the forest strip of Eastern Europe were forcing the settlers to massively cutting down the forests. Times of extensive development of agriculture were replacing by periods of crisis and desolation of settlements and their lands. Forests were coming back and then again were cutting down, and these lands again start to use as an arable land. Despite the fact that the territory of ancient Russia was very extensive and may be divided into many landscape zones that influenced the processes of settlement, archaeology helps to trace the development of these lands. At first, in the 10th-13th centuries, was settled the banks of major rivers and the tributaries. In the 14th-15th centuries, intensified the development of the water divided areas. From 16th century, the settlement system in most of the earlier settled regions of Moscow state reached its peak, appeared the maximum of rural settlements, which is fixed by census books. This is the territory of Moscow state in the middle of the 16th century. I am trying to reconstruct the cultural landscape of Tver uyezd using census books. Uyezd is a special term. It means a district, the lands around the city. Tver uyezd were one of the central regions of the Moscow state. Green area here is a historical territory of this uyezd. Census books. Census books are the Russian late medieval cadastral documents, which is a land descriptions of separate territories of the Moscow state. Census books carry information about the administrative borders, rural settlements and inhabited areas or wastelands, their owners, the amount of arable land and hayfields, and so on, etc. These materials allow enough detail to reconstruct the cultural landscape of particular historical territories. To localize the settlement and landowning structures of the census books, I am use various cartographic materials of the end of 18th-19th century. It mostly the materials of the general land survey of the late of 18th century, which is included general plans of the uyezds and so-called economic nodes. I am also using other maps, even outdated maps. The research uses GIS based on quantum GIS software application. Using the medieval censuses, cartographic materials of subsequent centuries and contemporary satellite images and open geodata allow exploring the administrative, settling and landowning structures. Here you can see the reconstruction of the administrative territory of Tver uyezd of the middle of the 16th century. But reconstructing those settlement and landowning structures, there is a question. When do they were formed? We have no written sources of the previous time, so archaeology supposed to help here. According to the archaeological map, which is special edition, collected data on all archaeological sites of Tver region on 2003, we have 112 relevated archaeological sites of 14th-17th century on the historical territory of the uyezd. 44 of them related with settlements of census books. Meanwhile, according to the census books, we can talk about 5,000 settlements on this territory in the middle of the 16th century. So the map represented here rather reflects the level of study of the territory than the system of rural settling in the late Middle Age. So archaeological sites related with rural medieval settlements researched not enough. Within the project, an archaeological research of the historical territory of Tver uyezd started to be provided. At the researching area related to a number of medieval villages, some of them can be correlated with the settlements of the census books. Other settlements of other census books can be found by means of archaeological exploration in future. However, medieval rural settlements left behind a very thin cultural layer or horizon. The vast majority of them are not stratified, and in most cases they have been repeatedly plowed up, many of them being plowed now. Researching of these sites is limited to collection of lifting material, mainly ceramics, on the arable land. You can try to fix the borders of the settlements by the area of distribution of ceramics and so on. But the collection of ceramic material could make it possible to make conclusions about the chronology of the development of settlements. But these materials have nothing to be compared with, because the ceramic chronological scale has not been developed. For the creation of the ceramic chronological scale, it is necessary to study the closed archaeological complexes. We need to discover and research the areas that have been used in the Middle Ages but were excluded from the economic turnover in the subsequent time. How we can do it? First of all, how we are localizing settlements of the census books at all. Here you can see the description of the land tenure of the Savatiev monastery. The record starts with the mention that Savatiev monastery owns. Then comes the list of its ownership. One large center, Село Клобуково, and a lot of little villages around it. The localization of the monastery itself, as well as the localization of Клобуково, that's not difficult. We can find them at the map of the 19th century and even at the modern maps, because these places still exist. Different situation with other settlements. Most of them ceased to exist. Some of them could not live through the economic crisis of the second half of the 16th century. Another were destroyed during Polish-Moscovite War of the 1605-1618, and so-called Time of Troubles. For example, here you can see the mention of Onikeyevo village, which one was the part of the land tenure of the Savatiev monastery. How we can localize it? As you can see, this map represents the borders of various land tenures of the 19th century. Some of them consisted of settlements, others just empty territories. These empty territories is wastelands. Most of these wastelands had their names, which were fixed during the general land survey of the late of 18th century. The economic notes to the general land survey allow correlating the names of wastelands with the separate late tenures, which helps to localize some of settlements of the census books. So we can find this territory. You see that it's number 131. We're trying to find the land tenure with the number 139. And it means that it's there. So we can find the territory where was located that Onikeyevo village of census books. Correlating this territory with modern satellite map, you can see that it is covered by woods. There was wooded area in the middle of the 19th century too. According to the censuses books of the 17th century, the Onikeyevo village ceased to exist. If this area was not plowed in 19th century, it seems not to be plowed in 17th, 18th centuries also. Since the end of the 16th century to the end of 17th century, the level of economic development of this territory significantly degraded. So, it seems to be that this territory have been used in the late Middle Ages, but were excluded from the economic turnover in the subsequent time. Because of that, it seems to be very suitable for the archaeological research of this site as a closed archaeological complex. So, using the medieval censuses, cartographic materials of subsequent centuries and contemporary satellite images and open geodata allow exploring the development of the landscape from the 16th to the 21st century. Generalizing of all of these materials in GIS allows correlating data on medieval landscapes with the location of known medieval archaeological sites. Reconstruction of both settling and landowning structures of the 16th century allows to discover the areas that have been used in Middle Ages but were excluded from the economic turnover in the subsequent time. These areas could retain the least damaged monuments of medieval archaeology. Studying these sites have a great importance for disclosure of the chronology of the formation of the settlement system and for research of the material culture of various feudal property. As you can see, I am speaking only about searching archaeological sites. The research of these sites is not successful, such successful as it's supposed to be, but we're trying to work on it. Thanks, that's all.